Victoria develops a computer game to sell on a gaming website. She writes her program using English-like statements. Victoria uses two different types of translator when creating the program for the computer game. State which translator is the most suitable for the given tasks. Give the benefit of using that translator for the task. You must choose a different translator for each task. The first thing we need to figure out is if we're speaking about high-level languages or low-level languages. Examples of high-level languages would be languages such as Python, Java, or JavaScript. Low-level languages would include assembly or machine code. The question says that Victoria writes her program using English-like statements. Low-level languages such as assembly and machine code are usually comprised of abbreviations or even hexadecimal or binary code, whereas high-level languages such as Python, Java, or JavaScript comprise of English-like statements. So here we are speaking about high-level languages. When using a high-level language, we need to translate the source code into a low-level language so that it can be executed by our CPU. We have two different types of translators. We have a compiler and we have an interpreter. In the question, they tell us that we must choose a different translator for each task. So one of these is going to be compiler. One of them is going to be interpreter. Let's work out which one is which. The first statement says to translate the code during development of the game. The second statement says to translate the final program and upload to the website for distribution without the source code. A compiler generates what's known as the object code, which is usually stored in an executable file. This file can be executed by the processor, and the source code is not contained within this file. The interpreter, on the other hand, does not create a file that can be executed. Instead, it executes the source code of the program line by line. If there are errors in the code, an interpreter will stop at the line where it finds an error and will output the error to the user. A compiler, on the other hand, will log the error and the line where it found the error in a log file, and once it's checked all of the lines of the file, it will output all of the errors for the user to see. For this reason, an interpreter is usually better when translating the code during development. So let's go ahead and write interpreter. The reason why we'd want to use an interpreter in this case is because the errors are going to be immediately reported, meaning that it is easier to debug the program. That means that the answer to the second statement is going to be a compiler. They've told us that the program is going to be uploaded to a website for distribution without the source code. We said that a compiler creates an executable file that does not contain the source code. This is beneficial, as it means that other people will not be able to steal the source code and can only run the executable file. Let's write that down for the benefits. Creates an executable file, meaning the source code cannot be stolen. And there we go. That is that question completed.